गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, खुशी गुड आफ्टरनून, शक्ति गुड आफ्टरनून. ओके, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद एक्सपेंडिंग मार्केट्स. ओके, वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड विद एक्सपेंडिंग मार्केट्स, सो दिस इज नंबर टू दैट वी विल स्टार्ट विद एक्सपेंडिंग मार्केट्स. ओके, पार्ट टू वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन टिल कॉम्बिनेशन स्ट्रैटेजी. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन व्हाट इज एक्सपेंडिंग मार्केट. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन दैट एक्सपेंडिंग ऑफ मार्केट is how after liberalization, privatization, globalization, after the reform of 1991 government, after the government has reformed 1991, that public sector will become, can become a private sector. Liberalization means loss of freedom was given to expand the market. To expand the market due to some, before that, before 1991, the privatization was having a lots and lots of problem. They were having a problem of issue of exporting license, trade, and after the reform of 1991, government has allowed that anyone can open their private companies. And this is way how the market had expanded. This is the way how market expanded and domestic companies around the world has gone globally, which is not only the internal, which is not only intensifying competency, but also give rise to range few activities in the market. Okay, now what are the activities? How they have, how the market has developed? What was the new thing that markets developed? New strategies was there. Okay, now then existing strength, leverages means advantage. Now, finance moving here and then availability of finance was there. Realization of need of growth of the business enterprise was there. Obviously, we all know that a time where a new business is standing, the people has to follow this rule. SPG. What is SPG? Survival, profit, and then growth. Survival, at first stage a business should survive, then profit, then growth. Okay, so survival, profit, and growth. Okay, now to apply this all the strategies was made to apply, to expand, and to become a stable in the market. All the strategies was made. The strategy was stability, maintaining strategies, expansion, growth. How you will maintain the stability in the market, how expansion, how the growth will come. What were the strategies for growth? What the market should follow? And retrenchment and divestment strategies. What decisions and what new thing should be done? Okay, what should be removed and what should be come into the effort? That is retrenchment and divestment strategies, and combination of all the other strategies was done. Okay, combination of all the other strategies was also done. So we have already completed with this part. Now, market expansion grids is the two market, that is current market and new market. All depend upon the products. Okay, now market presence strategy, product development strategy, market development strategy, diversification strategy. If current market is there, then present strategy we have to do. What was the present strategy that should be followed in the market? Means how to attract clients, how to sell the products. That is product development strategy we have to do with the new products. And new market, market development strategy. How to develop our market. Like we have to, in the new market, already there will be an existing product and you are creating to the new market. Will the existing product, how will you sell the existing product? Okay. Whether you have to, how the existing product will come to the, how the buyers will come to buy the existing product. That is diversification strategy we have to find it. Now we will read it very clearly. So, market present market penetration strategy. What is market? A strategy to grow by encouraging existing customers. By encouraging existing customers to buy more of the firm's current product is said to be penetrating strategy. This strategy is used when the customers are aware of the product but are not using. Customers are aware of the product but are not using. So the enterprise attempts to increase the sale of the current products in the current market by adopting the following approaches. So what are the approaches? That when the customers are not buying the current product, what are the approaches? That is, encourage frequency of use. What is the use of that particular? They encourage them to use that particular product. So encourage customer for more use of product by increasing the frequency of use. Example, brush twice a day with XYZ toothpaste to prevent cavities. Very good example. Very, very good example. People know that these are the toothpastes that are there in the market. But suppose that in our house, we always from the beginning, our grandfather and grandmother, our mother always used to buy Colgate. But now the current product is different. Colgate with different flavors, Colgate with something different problems that can decrease your problems. Okay, so but as we are used to buy that old product Colgate with simple Colgate, no flavors, so we always buy that. So we are not buying that. So more of advertisement of the current product, which make the consumer attract to the current product and use of the frequency use of that product is increased. Okay, so the first strategy is increase the frequency of the use of the current product. Part B, using per use. Example, good morning Nyasha, good afternoon Nyasha. Every time you shampoo your hair with Sigma, repeat it twice for shiny and silky hair. So use per use means once. Nowadays what everywhere you will say, everywhere you will go, they will tell you, you are at least 3 times in a week you should shampoo your hair. Why they are telling you? Because they want to increase their sale. Because they want to increase the more of the use of the product, the more you will buy. Isn't it? That is the increase. That is the strategy to use the product and sell the product. Okay. Attract new clients. If an enterprise is successful in making non-users for a product, the users of the product, it will definitely be able to increase its sales. Non-users could be attracted towards the product by using any of the following sale promotion. For that, we have to do the sale promotion techniques. That is advertisement, discount, samples, per selling, coupons. Now, suppose I will give you a good example. Example of Lay's and example of normal local chips. Like you have heard Motu Patlu, Lay's, Motu Patlu, Cracks and Rings, all this. So what are the attractive things they have done? They have given gifts inside it. And every time they change the gifts. So this make the people to buy more of local products than to the branded product. Okay. So these are the things how market penetration strategies goes on. Okay. Now coming to attract competitors, customers. How will you, that only I have given the example Lay's and that thing. Branded company and non-branded company. I've given you one example. Okay. Now we will read because it is very important. If the company succeed in making the customers to switch from the competitor's brand to the company's brand, while at the same time customers interact, then there will be definite increase in company's sale. Example, just read the exam. Examples are very important in your BST also and in your entrepreneur also. Okay. Hindustan Lever adopted the strategy of multi-branding with the aim of capturing the market by winning the customers of the competitors. The main aim is what? That you have to win others' customers. Okay. They introduce many brands in soaps and detergents market so that no segment is left untouched. It has Dove in the ultra premium segment, Lifebuoy in the economic segment, and Rexona, Lyril, and Lessani in the intervene segment. Okay, there are different segments. Okay, ultra premium spot where global is there. Globally, it is distributed. And Rexona, Lyril, Lessani in some of the places where it is very high demanded. Okay. Market development strategy. The second is what? Market development strategy in the new markets. Okay. Market development strategy involves selling the firm existing products to the, underline this, selling the firm's existing products to the new market, both nationally and internationally. It also aims in identifying new groups of customers. The new group of customers can be searched in terms of new demographic market. What is new demographic market? Demographic are used to characterize customers based upon the income, material status, standard of living, education, age, and sex. Okay, we will read the example also. Thus, herein the entrepreneur, most probably what we are seeing, existing market and new. Here market development strategy is what? That is comparison of two things. Existing product into the new market. Existing product, new market. Existing product and new market. There is a comparison of these two we have to bring into one place. So what will be the development strategy? These will be the new development. Thus, here in the entrepreneur who is currently selling existing product to a specific demographic group can now offer the same to a different demographic group. Example, Tata Nano Caterer is a segment of middle income group, but it is upgraded version with trendy colors and additional features is targeted towards the young generation. Okay, already that Tata is in the market, is in the existing market. When he brings with the new, with the customized new brand of car, okay, new brand name of car, then it is for the demographic. Is demographic means particular period, particular people. Like we Indian are rational buyers. We Indian mostly are the rational buyers. Rational buyers means we are mostly from the middle class people where we want to invest something and where we can get with the investment, at least with the investment, more of satisfaction. Earning, like suppose we expense 5 rupees, our utility means our satisfaction should be of 10. We want the double of that satisfaction and we will buy that product till our satisfaction becomes constant. Means if we are buying 5 rupees product, then our satisfaction should come up to the 5 rupees. If it will decrease the satisfaction of 5 rupees, then we will stop buying. So that is for middle class. But what about the people who are earning high money, people who are very rich? So these products are usually sold for that type of people whose earning is very high, whose standard of living is very high, you are very educated. So these are the people. And so what did the Nano did? The Tata did that he has brought up to one brand which will be available for other middle income people. Okay. That Tata Nano upgraded version is for the young generation. So he is bringing the existing product with new market. Existing product means new market. It is for young people. It is for middle class people. It is for some people whose income is very high. So that type of product is known as the same product which is already there in the market, but again he is bringing into the new market with a new term, that is known as market development strategy. Okay. New product use. An entrepreneur might find out that people use his product in a way that was not intended and expected initially. This new knowledge of product use provides insight into how the product may be valuable to the new group of buyer. For example, aspirin, a painkiller, has been discovered to be good for heart too. Okay, that was good for the heart too. Now, new geographical market. Geographical market. Okay, the approach aims selling the existing. Geographical means some place. We are talking about particular place, that is geographical. Okay, within the domestic country, within the local area, that is the domestic market. This approach aims to selling the existing products into new locations and new markets. This has the potential of increasing sales of products by making it available to those customers who do not have access to it. Having a large customer base is always beneficial for a business as it helps to achieve economic of sale, reduce its risk and reduce its dependence on any one market. Okay. Counter attract a global firm of snatching their customers through better products or lower prices. Might discover that some foreign markets presents higher profit opportunities than the domestic market. However, before adopting this approach, entrepreneur must be aware customer preferences, their language, legal requirements, regional differences. Example, Nirma, which was initially confined to local Gujarat market, later expanded to regional and then to the national markets. Okay, like I'm giving you one example. For example, if I'll say about a China product. China product is very cheaper product. Okay. First, it used to be get in some places. When we saw that people from the other places are coming and consuming it from China, then what we did? We expand this market. We expand this market to whole of the country of India, which increases our customer also, which increases our economic sale also, China's economic sale, not our economic sale. Okay. Reduces the China's risk. So depending upon the market where the you should see the need, not only the need of the higher product but to the lower product and the local product also. Locality product and locality, a market should always depend upon the people living in that particular local area. Okay, now we will do global market. This is what how traditional market was affected. Now global market means out of India also and within the India also, international. One of the way find new geographic market for your product is to go global. The normal practices followed by entrepreneur worldwide is to first explore the new market within the country and then to move to the other countries in search for better market. For example, I told you if I talk about China product, then China first developed his own market, then he came to India. So that is also a China became a global market. Okay. However, going global initiates the need for taking various decisions which are discussed below. So there was a various discussion. Major discussion in international marketing are, number one, it must be weigh several risks by deciding strategically and logically where to go abroad or not. Which makes to enter, which market to enter, how to enter the foreign markets, the marketing program, marketing organization. That is the thing over here, the global market is there. Okay. Now, how is the way that methods of entering global market? How we will enter? By first, we will do indirect. It can be through. How we will enter the global market or foreign market? First, indirect export. What is indirect export? Normal way of going global to indirect export, occasionally exporting and passive level involvement where company exports from time to time. Like some seasonal. If I talk about some seasonal, that is indirect export. We are not going directly over there and selling. We are acquiring some middleman. Through independent and middlemen are being approached by them. Okay. Now, when the company makes commitment to expand through indirect exports, the least change in the company's product line, workforce, organization, investment, mission is involved in thus. It is convention mode of expanding. Now, what is it telling? That when the company wants to grow, now when he is continuously indirecting, expanding, then when the product is in demand, when the product is in demand, then we can have a direct export. Then we can have a companies eventually may decide to handle their own exports through the strategy of entering global market. The enterprise assumes somewhat greater risk and investment, but potential returns to increase. Now, the company can carry on direct exporting on several ways, such as through domestically based export, dimension export, through overseas sales branch and subsidies. Means how it can be have a divert that through domestically based export division, divisions of or departments, through overseas sales branch, subsidiary establishment, nominating foreign based agents, distributors, and this. And third is license. You don't have to learn everything, just indirect export, direct exports, and license you do. Okay. Contract manufacturing and joint venture. Contract means if you are doing some business with a contract, means for few years you are doing something, then also you can enter a good, like Sierra's open department stores in Mexico and Spain. They found qualified local manufacturer to produce many of its production. This not only significantly reduced Sierra's cost of production, but led to the company to earn environment revenue. This is very, very good company. Sierra's is very good company. Okay. Joint venture. You're doing some joint venture means that two companies joined together. Okay. For a particular product, like Godrej and GE is a joint venture formed by spinning off of the refrigerator business of Godrej and Boeing with GE USA, with Godrej holding 60% stake and GE is holding 40% stake. Okay. Godrej GE plans to consolidate in refrigerator business and enter into other white good manufacturing such as AC, dishwashers, etc. Learn this example. Okay. Then direct investment, obviously, example we will do. No doubt the firm exposes its large investment to the risk, buying partially or full interest in the local company by building its own enterprise. Example, Electrolux AB, a Swedish company and a world leader in the white good manufacturing, plans to invest about $100 million in India in next 3-4 years. Hennes took over Glaxo food business for ₹210 crore. So this was the business of India and was taken up by the other foreign companies. Who invested 100 million crore and was taken up by other company as 210. He was very profitable company. Okay. So this was a thing. Product development strategy will do next day, and diversification strategy will do next day, because your English class will start. So I'm ending up with this. Nothing is there. How to develop the product in the market. Okay. This one, integrative expansion we will do, and diversification means how to diversify your market, how to expand your market. Okay. So, okay. Shakti, okay. Okay. Thank you, students, for today. Any question? Okay. I'm switching off the class because your English class will start at 2 o'clock. Okay. So I have to go back. Thank you. Bye.